me playing at this festival, I kind of went down there knowing that it would be the last thing where a lot of people were gathered. It was a strange moment for me as a performer, but we made the most of it. My earliest childhood memories of music, my parents were just playing music nonstop. I feel like they were just soundtracking every moment of the day. And my dad had these massive Sherwin Vega speakers, and he would just blast stuff through them. And he had this taste that was like no other parent I thought had. He would kind of provide the tunes for my childhood. It wasn't until I was maybe 7 or 8 and I really found an interest in drumming. It kind of got to a point where I would get pots and pans from the kitchen and I'd get the chopsticks out and drum along to the stuff that my dad was listening to or watching. From then it was just all go. I just wanted to absorb everything I could. I just knew that I liked groove and rhythm, and that was it. This festival I had just played, it was down in the Wairarapa called 121 Festival. There was talks about COVID-19 and the outbreak and what was happening in China and stuff. I'm pretty skeptical about most things that are hyped up in the media and all this kind of stuff. And this one really hit home, and I believed it. I knew that would get to a place where there was gonna be something drastic that changed. It just felt a little bit weird knowing that it was gonna be the last time we could do this for a while. Weirdly enough, after lockdown happened, it was this clarity that made me go a bit more tunnel vision with it all. It feels like there's a lot of external pressure in lockdown to come out of this thing with a new skill or use this time wisely and all this kind of stuff. And I don't think that's going to apply to everyone. I think when you're putting creative elements out into a public sphere, there's always that danger of expecting too much of yourself. And I think I'd gone through that personally. It was hard, and it was this thing where I was battling myself so hard to get the best out of myself that I really wasn't looking after the state of my mind. Maybe I'd lost a bit of hope in myself. That can be hard to take as a creator, because you need the best version of yourself to enjoy your art form. It was my first journey outside of my sphere. Going to just get like simple groceries just turned into this end of the world cinematic moment of me leaving my car and going into a different bubble. I tried to sort of, you know, sink into the regular element of me just doing a classic supermarket shop. We're sort of making these new memories, but it's under this really weird halo of existence. After lockdown, it's about us all getting together as Kiwi artists. It's made our bubble so much smaller, but I feel like that's something that we can flip into a really positive thing, just strengthening that community. And I think if we all come together, it's just gonna make the whole New Zealand sound a bit stronger. This lockdown has made me learn a few things about myself in the way of just being comfortable with my own rhythm and that being a safe place also. Weirdly enough, I've got all this time in the daytime to do whatever I want now, but my most productive moments are at night, so I'm still the 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. guy. None of us really know where it's gonna go. It can be a really exciting thing, but it can be a really daunting thing as well. I think with change comes, you know, a lot of growth. So I think I'm on that tip. I like to stay in that zone. My blue eyes got you reminiscing about a good time.